हेलो एवरीवन, माई सेल्फ वैभव वर्मा एंड आई एम अ पार्ट ऑफ लेक्सिस एंड कंपनी एज अ लीगल इंटर्न। दिस इज़ सेकेंड वीडियो ऑफ द टॉपिक डेफामेशन। इन दिस वीडियो आई एम गोइंग टू टॉक अबाउट रीसेंट केस लॉ। वी हैव हर्ड दैट सलमान खान फाइल्ड डेफामेशन सूट अगेंस्ट द के आर के कमाल आर खान। वी ऑल्सो सी दैट दैट KRK has criticized the Salman Khan's movie Radhe in a very drastic way, even though he even said that in interval he thought what he was watching and all. And after that we have seen a news that Salman Khan filed a defamation suit against KRK, that is Kamal R Khan. So does the suit has been filed on the basis of criticism done by KRK? The answer is no. Even though the legal team of Salman Khan clears the doubt amongst the public that Salman Khan hasn't filed defamation suit regarding the criticism of Radhe. Instead, Salman Khan has filed suit because KRK has been publishing and endorsing defamatory allegation, including that Salman Khan is corrupt and that he and his brand, Being Human, are involved in fraud, manipulation and money laundering transactions, that Salman Khan and his film are decoys. On the basis of this statement, Salman Khan filed a defamatory suit against Kamal R Khan. Move further and let's see other topic, which is essentials of defamation. Basically, what are essentials needed to be considered to be a offense of defamation? Number one, statement must be defamatory. It is one of the essentials of the defamation that statement made by a person against a aggrieved person must be a defamatory statement, which tends to lower the reputation of the aggrieved person or say plaintiff. Let's say a person tells B that C is a drunkard or smoker. So such statement considered to be a defamatory statement. A person cannot take defense that the statement was not intended not to be defamatory, although it caused a feeling of hatred, contempt or dislike. For example, a publication of an advertisement in a local newspaper that the company of B has committed fraud of rupees 20 lakh. Now this statement will amount to be a defamatory as the newspaper will be read by many of the people and will surely injure the reputation of B's company. Let's take another example, that is A, an employer scold his employee B for not coming on time in front of whole staff. The B cannot take the plea that A has injured the reputation of B. Here, mere hasty expression spoken in anger or vulgar or abuse, to which no hearer attribute any set purpose to injure the character, would not amount to defame a person. The second essential is statement must refer to plaintiff. Statement must refer to the plaintiff. It will be immaterial that defendant did not intend to defame the plaintiff if the person to whom the statement was published could reasonably infer that statement referred to him, then defendant would be liable for an offense of defamation under section 499. For an example, if a bank publishes a notice to all its branches to not to give the loan to any person from PQR state, as the people of PQR are more often repeated defaulters. Because of this, a member of B, a member of PQR, has suffered a huge loss. B can hold A liable for defaming him. Altogether, the bank did not directly focus on him. Basically, in this example, B is a resident of such and such state, upon which the bank issue a state notice to its branches, and he suffered a huge loss because of this statement. So he can file a suit against the bank ऑन बेसिस ऑफ दैट स्टेटमेंट, ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ दैट नोटिस, ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ दैट नोटिस गिवन टू अदर ब्रांचेस ऑफ द बैंक, ऑल दो दैट दैट स्टेटमेंट डज नॉट रिलेट टू और डज नॉट स्पेशली फोकस ऑन बी. थर्ड एसेंशियल इज स्टेटमेंट मस्ट बी पब्लिश्ड. वी हैव सीन दैट स्टेटमेंट मस्ट बी डेफामेटरी, येस. स्टेटमेंट मस्ट बी रेफर टू द प्लेंटिफ, येस. बट इफ द पब्लिकेशन ऑफ द स्टेटमेंट हैज़ नॉट बीन डन, लाइक इट नॉट बीन स्पोकन टू एनी वन, इट नॉट बीन इवन दो इट नॉट बीन कन्वे द स्टेटमेंट टू द प्लेंटिफ, सो इट बी कंसिडर्ड एज अ डेफामेशन. डेफामेटरी स्टेटमेंट मस्ट बी पब्लिश्ड फॉर अलेजिंग द ऑफेंस ऑफ डेफामेशन. पब्लिकेशन ऑफ डेफामेटरी स्टेटमेंट टू सम पर्सन अदर देन द पर्सन डिफेम इज मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टेंट एस्पेक्ट फॉर मेकिंग एनी पर्सन लाइबल, एज अनलेस एक्ट इज डन, नो एक्शन फॉर डेफामेशन विल लाई. इन सिंपल मीनिंग्स लाइक वी कैन से दैट फॉर कंस्टिट्यूटिंग डेफामेटरी ऑफेंस, डेफामेशन ऑफेंस, द स्टेटमेंट मस्ट बी पब्लिश टू द अदर पब्लिक एज वेल एक्सेप्ट द प्लेंटिफ इटसेल्फ. ओनली इशू ओनली कन्वे द मैसेज और ओनली ओनली कन्वे द स्टेटमेंट टू द प्लेंटिफ डायरेक्टली डज नॉट कॉन्स्टिट्यूट अ डेफामेशन सूट. इफ अ थर्ड पर्सन रॉन्गफुली रीड्स अ लेटर मेंट फॉर द प्लेंटिफ, देन द डिफेंडेंट लाइकली टू बी लाइबल. बट इफ द डेफामेटरी लेटर सेंड टू द प्लेंटिफ is likely to be read by somebody else, there will be a valid publication. This will be a valid publication. In case Mahendra Ram versus Harnandan Prasad, defendant was held liable for sending a defamatory letter to the plaintiff written in Urdu, knowing that the plaintiff did not know Urdu and the letter will be very likely to be read by some other person. Thank you.